Dear comrades, the European Parliament delegation of the Communist Party of Greece, the Intersection Committee for Refugees and Immigrants of the Central Committee of the Communist Party of Greece, dear comrades from the labor movement, unions and local representatives, we are saluting you with sincere greetings and our wishes of solidarity and congratulate you for organizing this meeting on a very critical and contemporary topic. We also salute the 103rd anniversary of the foundation of our fraternal party, Communist Party of Greece, by means of this message. In the first place, we are noting clearly that imperialism, uneven development and unceasing conflicts between powers are the root cause of wars and forced migration. In all countries linked with the imperialist system, in almost all parts of the world where refugees are present, this issue becomes a matter of blackmailing between governments, a pretext for intervention with sovereign rights of one country, and the burden is always left to those who are already oppressed, to the exploited workers from all backgrounds. As for Turkey, which is now the country with the highest official number of refugees and probably more unofficially around 4 to 5 million people, we cannot separate the refugee policy of the government from its other reactionary anti-worker policies. The AKP government is a fully pro-market, pro-imperialist authority with nationalism and Sunni Islamism as pillars of its doctrine. Its policy of neo-Ottomanism, which corresponds to attaining economic, political and bargaining power in the former territories of Ottoman Empire, its engagement with the Muslim Brothers Network throughout the so-called Arab Spring, and its collaborationist policies in the imperialist intervention to the Middle East and North Africa, all resulted in devastation of the lives of millions. Turkish bourgeoisie and its current political representative, the Erdogan government, did not hesitate to sign a 6 billion euro deal with the EU, aiming to serve as a barrier for refugees in order to prevent them from entering the borders of the EU. This deal, on the one hand, clearly shows that human life is worth less than money in the accounts of the allegedly democratic and humanistic EU. On the other hand, it shows that the Turkish government is ready to use the situation of the country as a manipulation tool. Before and during the pandemic, we have witnessed shameful occasions of refugees being pushed to the borders and other cruel attempts or threats against them. The government threatened the EU, saying that they will let the refugees off the borders, as if they were not speaking of real people but objects. On top of this, they take immigrants and refugees as cheap labor power with a very high ratio of exploitation. They mostly work in temporary positions in textile, construction, cleaning and care sectors, and seasonally in agriculture. Although some of them who have a higher financial or educational background are employed in other sectors such as health, or become self-employed as translators, interpreters, shop owners, etc., the majority have to earn their living with very low salaries and live under poor conditions. Informal, unregistered work is very common, so is unemployment. Through this wider reserve army of workers, the bourgeois government achieves greater bargaining powers against the representatives of the working class and unions. More, early and forced marriages, unwanted pregnancies, violence against women, children, and bullying at the workplaces are also much present. The approach of the bourgeois opposition to the issue is also very unhealthy and is totally reflecting their class perspective, which is a capitalist one. The two dominant parties in that front, the CHP and GUP party, advocate for the return of refugees or sending them back to their own countries. Some other party representatives explicitly declare or conduct xenophobia, such as their mayors denying some rights from refugee inhabitants. We can say that this xenophobic approach is partially shared by the middle class of the country, who are more concerned with their own individual life than the catastrophe the country is facing. With regards to Western-oriented foreign policy or pro-market tendencies, the bourgeois opposition is no different from the existing government. In essence, they don't propose a real solution to the problem. The real solution has to be based on a socialist approach. Exploitation should come to an end, unemployment must be banned, racism must be considered illegal and criminal. The ties with the imperialist governments and organizations such as the USA, the EU and NATO should be broken, and all the obligations and military missions brought by these ties should be terminated. This is our position. Let me also share with you that as of 2020, following the 13th Congress of our party on its 100th anniversary, we took the collective decision of forming an immigrant workers' bureau that was specifically aimed to report on the living and working conditions of immigrant workers, organize struggles in the name of equal rights, and disseminate emancipatory thoughts among them, eventually gaining them to the ranks of communist struggle. Through the Bureau and our base organizations, we are making efforts to overcome language, cultural, and logistical barriers in front of organizing. Moreover, another aim of the Bureau is to identify and disclose the strategies of various actors in the field, with a specific focus on some NGOs that are liberal and or reactionary in terms of their ideological background and funded by various bourgeois institutions, foundations or imperialist organizations such as the EU. While it is pleasing that some of these steps have resulted in gains for us, we are aware that there is much more to be done. Discrimination, racism, exclusion of people, xenophobia belong to the ideology of the dominant exploitative class. Internationalism, proletarian fraternalism and solidarity are the values of communists. We should not allow any shadow to be cast over these deep-rooted values. Of course, in this short message, we could only basically share our vision on this issue, and we believe we should continue exchanging views and experiences. Let me end with emphasizing the joint camp of the youth organizations of both parties last year in Mytilene, which was a clear example of addressing these values and the practice that we believe we should continue. Receive our comradely greetings on behalf of the Communist Party of Turkey. We wish very much successes to your meeting.